So now come to lecture number 2, example number 2. Question is, find the measure of the angle. Find the measure of the angle of an equilateral triangle. Okay, so before solving this question, I want to tell you that what is equilateral triangle. Okay, so equilateral triangle you know that of the sum of a triangle is what, 180 degree. But equilateral triangle means whose all sides are equal, means A, B, C. If it's equilateral triangle, if AB is equal to BC is equal to CA, and its all sides angle is what, 60 degree. This should be also 60, this should be also 60, and this should be also 60, okay? And one is isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, only two sides are equal, and one sides are unequal. But in equilateral, all sides are equal. Okay? So now we find, so we have to find the measure of the angle of an equilateral, means only one, any one angle we have to find. So how we will find? We know that the all angles of an equilateral triangle are what? Congruent means what? Equal. Okay, we know that all angles of an equilateral triangle are equal. So therefore each angle is equal to, now we know that first that the sum of a triangle is 180 degree. And how many angles are there? If there are 3 angles are there, so divide it. So when you will divide, you will find 60 degree. It means each angle will be 60 degree. Answer will be 60 degree. That's why I have told you that in equilateral triangle, all angles are of 60 degree and all sides are congruent. So this is the solution of example number 2. Now come to page number 143, example number 3. Now one of the two equal angles of an isosceles triangle measure 50 degree. Find the third angle. So before explaining this question, see, isosceles triangle, it is also a triangle which is bounded by three sides. But in this, only two sides are equal. If AB equal to AC, AB is equal to AC, and this BC will not equal. Okay, only two sides are equal. It can be BC is equal to AB. Only two sides are equal. So question is, at one of the two equal angles of an isosceles triangle is 50 degree. It means if this is 50 degree and this will be also, because if two sides are equal, if AB is equal to AC, it means their angle will be also equal. So here two sides, it is given 50 degree and 50 degree. Okay? So what we will do, sum of the measure of two angle is what? 50 degree plus 50 degree is 100 degree. Okay, because two angles are equal. Yeah, so let's, we know that two sides are equal and two angles are equal. So two angles measure is what? 50 plus 50 is 100 degree. So therefore third angle is equal to what? 180 minus 100, means third angle measure is 80 degrees. Why? Because we know that the sum of the measure of a triangle is 180. This always keep in your mind, that sum of the measure of a triangle is 180. If it is equilateral triangle, if it is isosceles triangle, if it is scalene triangle, okay, any triangle will be there. What you have to keep in your mind, their sum of the measure of the triangle is 180 degree. Okay, so now we come to example number 4. I hope whatever I am explaining you understand. Example number 4. If none equal angle of an isosceles triangle, if none equal angle of an isosceles triangle is 70 degree, find the other two angles. Okay, you have to find the other two angles. See, what you have to do here first. Isosceles triangle, I already told you that two sides are equal and one side are equal. AB is equal to BC does not equal to sorry AB is equal to yes AB is equal to AC does not equal to BC. Means assume that angle B is equal to angle C but does not equal to angle A. Okay, question is, if none equal angle of an isosceles triangle, means none equal means the angle which is not equal to other two. If this is 70 degree, we have to find this angle and you have to find this angle. Question is given, none equal angle of isosceles triangle is given. So you have to find the other two angles. So you know that whatever angle will be this, same angle will be this one. Why? Because they are equal. So how you will find the same? So we know that first thing, the sum of the measure of the three angles of a triangle is what? 180 degree. So this you have to write in every question. The sum of the measure of three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So we know that one angle is given what? 70 degree. This none equal angle you have, it is given, and so therefore the sum of the measure of the two equal angles will be what? 180 degree minus 170 degree. So when you subtract, you will get 180. See, one angle is given 70. Now we know that the sum of the measure of these two equal angles will be 180 minus 70, 110 degree. Means these two equal sum. Now here we don't know that what will be that angle, this angle, and what will be this angle. We know this only, that their sum will be 180. This we know, that their sum will be 110 degree. But we have to find the sum of each angle. So therefore, the measure of each angle will be what? So we have to find the measure of each equal angle. Equal angle means how many equal angles are there in isosceles triangle? 2. So this 110 divided by 2. So 55. It means this will be 55 and this will be 55. Now when you will add, you will come 110 and this will come 70. So see, 180 degree. The sum of the measure of the three angle of triangle is 180 degree, and these two sides angle will be 55 degree each. till here I am stopping. In next class I will go for exercise 46. So for now, goodbye to all of you.